Chuck Mononoff, and this is a fantastic Yamaha C3 that we just finished. And this piano is for Henry. We got it all set up with a piano disc low profile system and a record system and a Scion system and everything. So I'm going to take this opportunity to give you a grand tour of everything that goes into one of these pianos that we put everything into. So I'm going to take it apart and show you exactly what all the components are and what goes into putting one of these together. Okay, so first thing we do is take the keyboard cover out, which I showed you. Now we're going to take key blocks out. Don't try this at home. Actually, I'm going to put this inside the piano. All right. What I'm going to show you is exactly how the mute rail works. And the first thing we're going to do is take the action out. We'll put it on this piano bench right here. This is the wire that plugs in the record strip. Okay, you want a camera come up on this and you see it. When you unplug it and plug it, there's these two tabs that meet in the middle right here. It's very, very important, but that's the way it goes in. It doesn't go in the other way, which one side has a tab and one doesn't. So you don't want to put it in like this. It always goes like this. Okay, so you want to unplug that, and then you very easily, first you make sure that the mute rail is off, which it is, because this would be the on position, and this would be the off position. Okay, so it's in the off position, and now you're going to slide the action out very, very, very carefully. Go. Okay. So now if the camera will come inside here, you see exactly how the mechanism works and all the workings, all the work that we did to the piano. Right here are all the solenoids, and they're underneath the backs of the keys, and you see they go up and they hit each key in the order that the computer tells them to, according to your software. And up here, all the way at the top, this is the mute rail, right here. And how that works is very simply, there's a lever over here, and when you pull this lever this way, it activates a cable, and the cable is over here, and if you see it, it pulls it down. See that? Up, down. The down position stops the hammers from hitting the strings. The up position allows the hammers to hit the strings. It's that simple. Then you put your headphones into this plug here, adjust your volume control, and when it's in the silent mode, you'll hear the onboard computer with the sounds inside this little box come into your headphones, which is pretty nifty. It's a really nice way to be able to practice and not disturb anyone. And that's essentially that. Now, it looks pretty simple, but the whole trick to this installation is the hole that you drill through this part of the piano, because it has to be exactly straight and even. It can't be crooked this way, crooked that way, up or down. It has to be exactly straight so it stops the hammers evenly all the way across the keyboard. So that's the most difficult part, believe it or not, of making this installation here. And if it's not done right, your result is not going to be excellent, which is what we strive for here. Okay, so, oh, and just to show you over here, this is a piano that we're working on, so you can see work in progress, the way it looks before we assemble the piano. The reason why it's here is because our piano disc technician does all the work to the piano that you see here. Takes the key bed off the piano, he makes this hole in here, he sets up the solenoids, so the solenoids line up with every single key, and you check it on the workbench before you assemble the piano. I do all this personally because I don't want to take a chance on the piano going out to its destination 1,000 miles away and there's something wrong and I have to send a piano technician or a piano disc technician, and the technician, you know, might say to me, oh, well, this was done wrong, that was done wrong. But I know it wasn't done wrong because I did it myself. So that's why I do the final assembly of every single piano that goes out of here personally. As you see, that's my desk over there. And I make sure that before it goes out that door, I see the piano, I finish it, I look at it, I make sure that it's perfect before it leaves here. And as you see, there's a white one, that's leaving this week. The one that I'm working on right now, that I'm showing you the video on, that's leaving this week as well. Incidentally, this is a shipment that just came in about a week ago. You see, we got about 15, 20 grand pianos that came in. And as you may or may not know, we get our pianos from Japan, and that's where this piano came from. So I'm gonna assemble this back, and now I'm gonna demonstrate the electronics. Now incidentally, when you put the action back in the piano, it's the same thing in reverse. Always make sure that the silent system is in the off position. Otherwise the hammers will hit that bar and you could break one off. So you have to be very careful. Now even some piano technicians don't know how to do this. So if you have a piano tuner and for some reason he wants to go inside your piano, just make sure he knows what he's doing before he does this, because you don't want to break a hammer. Now I'm plugging in the report strip into the processor. This little guy here, remember I said the two tabs have to meet? There we go. Boom. All set. Now it's connected. And in she goes. Where she stops, nobody knows. Okay. There it is. Okay. Now we're going to put it all back together. Okay, key blocks. These are key blocks. I hope Henry doesn't mind us taking his piano apart. In here, and you'd be able to hear the piano playing in your headphones. And there's also another neat feature that I'll show you in a little bit, where if you get tired of wearing headphones, you could actually turn the piano off and listen to the sound of the piano come out of the internal speaker at a very low volume, which is pretty neat. But anyway, let's go get underneath the piano here, and I'll show you what we have, what we've done to it. You good on this side, I'll go on this side. Okay, so underneath here, here are your components. This is the pedal solenoid. So when your software tells the pedal when to play, this goes down and pushes the pedal up. Okay. Over here on the pedal lever, this is the pedal solenoid lever. This is the sensor for the silent system in the record strip. So when this goes down, this sends a signal to sustain the electronic sound of the piano inside the pedal, inside the piano. Same thing for the shift lever. This is a sensor here for that. In other words, so when you press the shift pedal, or the soft pedal, which is on this side, you see it goes up, that sends a signal to the
to the computer or the processor for the silence system. It tells the tone module to lower the sound to dampen it. Over here is the processor. This is the Prodigy processor. And then over here is your speaker. Incidentally, this is very high quality Yamaha studio monitors that we use here, piano outlet. Nobody else uses these. But if you look underneath here, on the other side, the camera come around, you see the power strip. We're gonna switch positions. This is gonna be your on-off switch on this side here, okay? I would say it's a good idea if you're not using the piano to switch it off. On your speaker here, volume is always all the way at max. That's where we send it out, and that's where it should be set out, because you're gonna set the volume on the iPad for the speaker. That's pretty much it. One thing that we're gonna demonstrate here, since I'm under the piano right here, I'm gonna show you how to get the sound of the electronic piano out of your speaker if you wanted to play it at a low volume instead of headphones. So we're gonna take this RCA plug with this coupler here, unplug the speaker, boom, boom, okay. Take the other side, plug it into line out on the back here. Now, if I go over to the piano and play it, and this is if you don't want to use headphones, if you don't like that, that's me, I don't like to wear headphones, I like to have it at a low volume. So that's the sound of your piano. So now what we're going to do is turn on the mute, and now you have electronic piano, you can play at a very, very low volume. Instead of, turn the mute off. Pretty cool, right? So it gives you a lot of versatility. So I'm going to put it back the way it was, and now I'm going to demonstrate the piano disc system. Okay, so now I'm going to demonstrate how the Prodigy system works when you want to play your music, okay? So when you get your iPad and your piano, first thing that you want to check when you turn both on is that it's set up. You go into your settings here and make sure that it's connected to the processor inside the piano. And the way you'll see this is piano disc silent drive Bluetooth audio. Now, if you send me your iPad and I load it up with software for you, most likely I'll have your piano here and I'll be able to connect them here, so that when you get the piano and the iPad, it's going to connect automatically. If that doesn't happen, you'll have to reconnect it, and it's very simple. Just you connect it like any other Bluetooth device. All you do is look for PD silent drive Bluetooth audio, and you connect it. Over here, it's connected. It's all set to go. Okay. Your music is going to be in the IQ app, which looks like this. We're going to go into iPod library. There we go. And that's the screen that you're going to see. Now, the albums that have this type of artwork with no famous artists on it, it's usually going to be just piano. So if we try this right here, and we try some Debussy. Now, it should start playing. If it doesn't, you want to check first your volume control, okay? It should play from this level on up. And you want to click that little icon there to make sure that it's on PD silent drive Bluetooth audio, not iPad. If it's on the iPad, this is what you're going to hear. That noise, because that noise is what makes the piano play. It shouldn't be coming out of the speaker or the iPad. It should be coming out, that signal should be sent to the processor, to the piano. So in order to do that, we're going to click this, go back to here, and it shall stop playing again. Now that's piano only. The next thing that I'm going to demonstrate is piano with background music. So if we go back into our recordings here, and let's say we choose some Sting, one of these here, press play, Now, one thing is very important with the background music and the vocals along with the piano. Remember that the piano is supposed to be accompaniment, okay? So you want the piano to be in the background of the music, the featured music that you're listening to. In this case, the Alephus thing. So what you're gonna do is, you're gonna take this balance control and switch it more towards the background music. Now you see the piano's not playing, okay? But it will when you raise the master body. Sounds great, doesn't it? Yeah. The other type of software that we have is going to be your videos. Okay, so if you go back in here, back in there, you're going to see where we have videos, and absolutely one of our favorites is going to be Tony Bennett, and you got to pick Fly Me to the Moon.
Vance, can we turn all the microphones off?
So blow it up here.
Poets often use many words to say a simple thing. It takes thought and time and rhyme.
Turn that off. That really sounds good. I could just listen to that stuff forever. But anyway, so that pretty much covers all the features that you have with the piano. And getting back to the piano itself, this is a Yamaha C3. This is one of our pianos. Obviously, they've gotten in from Japan. You know, one other thing I always see on eBay and advertised, somebody will tell me when they're talking to me about buying a piano from me, they say, oh, I know a place. You know, so-and-so, they do the same thing that you do. Well, I can tell you right now, if you don't see a room, the piano's lined up like this, and back here, the camera back here, see our inventory up in that. We have every single model here, all different years, priced anywhere from $8,500 and on up. We have some beautiful models. As a matter of fact, right here, one of my favorite pianos, this one here. This is a Yamaha. Inside's dusty and dirty, but when they get sold, they get cleaned up and they look like Henry's piano. But this is a C5, and this actually has its own silent system too. This piano that I practice on, great sound. And then we have a piano that this one just came in yesterday. I actually sold this piano about 10 years ago to a customer, obviously locally here in South Florida. And then they decided to downsize, and I just got the piano back. And this piano is awesome. This is like my new favorite. This is the Yamaha C6, which is a 6'11". Just playing on these pianos in here because it's what we do here, what I do here. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope this gave you a lot of information on on the player system, the installation that we do, the quality that we do here at Piano Outlet. And also, if you have any questions, there's your contact information for me. Anyway, call me anytime. That's my direct number to this cell phone. So thank you very much for watching.